The condition that would come to be known as Graves' disease was first and briefly documented by the English physician Caleb Hiller Perry in the late 1700s, when he made the connection between an enlarged thyroid gland, rapid heartbeat, and cardiovascular complications. The real breakthrough in studying this disorder took place when Robert James Graves, an Irish physician, discovered in the 1830s that several of his patients not only displayed an enlarged thyroid gland with a rapid or regular heartbeat, but also an enlarged and protruding eyes. Graves later went on to theorize that a disturbance of the thyroid gland could be the cause of these medical conditions, as well as documenting that women seem to be suffering from this condition much more frequently than men. The theory that the thyroid could be at the heart of the medical issue involving eye and heart problems was later shown to be valid by the German physician Carl Adolf von Beistel. Graves' disease is an autoimmune disorder that affects the thyroid. Let's see what the thyroid is and what role plays in the homeostasis. The thyroid is the largest endocrine gland in the human body. It has a butterfly shape and it is located in the neck surrounding the trachea. The thyroid gland produces hormones that stimulate metabolism, facilitate the breakdown of carbs, proteins, and fats, stimulates heat production, increases cardiac output, stimulates glucose production and absorption, promotes growth and development of the cells, increases oxygen consumption, and stimulates physical and mental growth. The normal physiology of the thyroid hormone production. In normal functioning of the thyroid gland, the hypothalamus produces TRH, which are the thyroid-releasing hormones. TRH stimulates the anterior pituitary to produce TSH, which is the thyroid-stimulating hormone. The TSH binds onto the receptor proteins of the thyroid gland and stimulates the gland to produce thyroid hormones T3 and T4. These hormones are produced by the follicular epithelial cells of the thyroid using iodine from the diet. The hormones are released into the circulation where T4 is converted into T3, which is the active form. T3 and T4 work like steroid hormones and across the cell membranes, go into the nucleus, and turn on protein synthesis. The negative feedback loop regulates the production of the thyroid hormones. Abnormal thyroid hormone production with Graves' disease. In the setting of Graves' disease, the immune system produces autoantibodies known as TSIs. TSIs are thyroid-stimulating immunoglobulins. They act the same as TSH released by the pituitary. The autoantibodies with the TSH receptor stimulate the thyroid gland to produce more hormones than the body needs, mostly T3 stimulation. This overproduction of thyroid hormones is called hyperthyroidism. Graves' disease is the most common cause of hyperthyroidism. Symptoms of the disease: insomnia, increased heart rate, weight loss, muscle weakness, fatigue, mood swings, light menstrual flow, hot flashes, infertility, frequent bowel movements, goiter, which is the enlargement of the thyroid, protruding eyes, and ophthalmopathy. Ophthalmopathy is thought to result from the cytokines. It can cause severe eye problems such as diplopia and visual loss. Risk factors: stress, genetic, family history, smoking, pregnancy, contribution of the other autoimmune disorders, gender, and is usually onset between 20 to 40 years of age. The disease affects both men and women, but women are 10 times more likely to get the disease. Treatments: antithyroid medications, radioactive iodine treatment, and surgery to remove the thyroid gland. In summary, Graves' disease is triggered by some process in the body's immune system, which normally protects us from foreign invaders such as bacteria and viruses. The immune system destroys foreign invaders with substances called antibodies produced by the blood cells known as lymphocytes. Some people inherit an immune system that can cause problems. Their lymphocytes make antibodies against their own tissues that stimulate or damage them. In Graves' disease, antibodies bind to the surface of the thyroid cells and stimulate those cells to overproduce thyroid hormones. This results in an overactive thyroid. These same antibodies may also be involved in the eye changes seen in Graves' ophthalmopathy, since the receptors on the thyroid may also be found on the surface cells behind the eye. Physicians have long suspected the severe emotional stress, such as the death of a loved one, can set off disease in some patients.
Thank you.